I'm going to talk to you about how to choose a telescope, and particularly this video is just so that you understand some optical designs, which you need to do if you're going to choose a telescope. First thing to say is that a telescope has three parts, so the whole thing is a telescope. So people often think the telescope is just the tube, but the tube is called the OTA, the optical tube assembly. So the telescopes have three parts. So one part is the tube itself, the OTA. The second part is the mount, and the mount is the bit that moves the telescope, so like that. And the third part is the base, which in this case is a tripod. So with the telescope behind me, it's a Dobsonian telescope, which means that it's on a flat base. It's got an Alpaz mount, so it just rotates and goes up and down, and the OTA is a Newtonian reflector. There are two basic types of optical tubes, so one is a reflector and the other is a refractor. So the refractors are the telescopes that people are used to thinking about often, so just with the lens at one end and it's just a long skinny tube, so as you see there. With a reflector has a mirror, so two mirrors at least, and there are lots of complex designs. So for a beginner telescope, I've excluded all the complex designs because they're generally fairly expensive. So this telescope on my left, which you may be able to just see, is a Ritchie Chretien 10-inch telescope, so an RC10. And so it's a reflector with a big mirror at the bottom, but it still has the eyepiece at the bottom. Those sorts of designs generally, they're not good to start with, simply because of the cost. So with this telescope, this is a Newtonian reflector, so I just mirror at the base, I mirror at the top. It's a very simple design. All telescopes, regardless of the optical design, are described with two numbers, which is the aperture and the focal length. And it's useful to understand what those two numbers mean. So the aperture is just the size of the eye that you're looking at with the sky. So it's about how much light can you gather. And aperture does two things. So it makes things brighter, because we're often looking at things that are very dim. It's not that we have to magnify that much. It's often that it's just that they're very dim. Aperture is what determines how much magnification you can get. So while focal length, which we'll talk about, talks about magnification, the limit of your telescope for magnification is about the aperture. So how big it is this way. So this surface area. And it's a pretty simple rule. The maximum magnification you can get is 2 times your aperture in millimetres. So this is a 350mm telescope, which means that in theory its maximum magnification is 700 times. But in practice, most of the time the atmosphere limits you to about 250 anyway. So this telescope is the Leverstar 90, so it's a 90mm telescope. And so its theoretical maximum magnification is 180 times. It's 90mm, 90 times 2, it's 180. Which is exactly what you get with the supplied eyepieces with this. It gets out to 180. So some very cheap telescopes will make claims about magnification which are just laughable because the aperture won't support it. Aperture also gets much, much better as you get bigger, because this is about the light gathering area. So it's about the surface area there. And the surface area, or the size of it, is the size of a circle. So it's pi r squared. So that if you make the aperture twice as big, then you're gathering 4 times the amount of light, because it's squared. If you make it 3 times as big, you're gathering 9 times the amount of light, because it's squared, so that you go up very quickly. The second figure to think about is the focal length. And the focal length is about how far the light travels before it gets to a focal point. What it means in practice is that long focal lengths, so say this telescope has a focal length of 1,450 millimetres, so that's reasonably long. This telescope is about 2,000 millimetres. What that means is that it makes the telescope naturally magnify a lot, so it works a bit like a zoom lens, which means that you see a very small part of the sky. People think if I get a long focal length telescope, it will magnify better, but magnification is about aperture, because you could always magnify as much as you want, or as little as you want, by the choice of eyepiece. So this telescope is a 600 millimeter focal length, which means it's relatively short. What that means is it's a bit more like a wide angle lens compared to a telescope like this. So this telescope with its big aperture naturally sees a much smaller part of the sky, much tinier patch of sky than this one does. So with the same eyepiece in each of these, I will see a bigger field of view in this telescope than in this telescope, which means that you can see larger things, and often they're very big. So Andromeda, for example, the galaxy Andromeda, that's bigger than the full moon, but it's just very faint. So with the choice of telescope thing, it's worthwhile keeping in mind what those two numbers mean, about aperture and focal length. And remembering that if you have a shorter focal length, you're going to have a wider field of view, it will be easier to point and find things, and then you use different eyepieces to magnify.